eye on the NHL. The Sabres look to prove that they're for real as they face off against the Lightning. The Wild aim to prove that they're the hottest team in the league with the win over the defending champs, and the Sharks hope to prove that those early struggles are nothing to worry about as they face off against the Predators. I'm Lexadette. All that and more is On the Fly. Starts right now.
Sundquist.
Whoa.
As he gets cleaned out by Wilson. Sundquist stays down.
Sundquist is not moving right inside the blue line.
Wilson is making his way down that dressing room tunnel. He expects this to be costly.
And this is breaking news here. Tom Wilson had an in-person hearing this morning for his hit in the preseason. He's getting 20 game for that hit.
That is a big-time statement from the NHL.
The early portion of the season has been tough on the reigning Stanley Cup Washington Capitals. They're tied for sixth place in the Metro Division, and they're losers of two straight. But Caps did get some good news on Tuesday. Tom Wilson's 20-game suspension for that preseason hit on Oscar Sundquist, that was reduced to 14 games by a neutral arbitrator. So Wilson, who has served 16 games of the ban, took the ice for the first time this year as Washington traveled to Minnesota to take on the Wild. Let's hear what Tom Wilson had to say earlier on Tuesday about the reduction of that suspension.
First good day in a while. It was definitely a nice text to get, and you know, the possibility of being in tonight, and just kind of started the day off on the right foot, and obviously pretty excited to play some hockey again. Had lots of time to think about it and dissect parts of my game and stuff, and at the end of the day, it's on me, and I have to control that better and make sure I'm out there playing.
Through center, Burakovsky. Further still, Lars Eller streaking out wide. Eller turns, throws the stiff arm out, walks it all the way to the point. Connecting there for a snapshot, score! Dmitry Orlov.
What a play all around, but it's all Lars Eller. Did he ever do the alley-oop up around the blue line? Some good crossovers. He created separation. Then that opened up for the defenseman sneaking in, and Dmitry let it fly. Top shelf glove. His first goal in about 19 games.
The Caps are 5-1 this season when they strike first. Tom Wilson returning to the lineup for Washington, 43 in the white. The independent arbitrator reducing his suspension. Look at Orlov skipping there for Wilson. He scores! Tom Wilson on the board.
Welcome back, Big Tom. Dubnyk's banged up after taking the thrust of that hit after Wilson had already put the puck into the net.
Of course, Tom Wilson's right in the middle of that.
Got a skate into the midsection of Dubnyk, it appeared. And Dubnyk's knees buckle underneath him, but it really looked like Suter initiated the contact with Wilson to knock him into the goaltender.
Looks like the big man's going to battle through it.
Here we go. Tom Wilson, crash, bang, boom.
Wilson is coming over to take a goalie interference penalty. Boudreau and his team go to the power play.
Granlund is the top power play scorer for Minnesota. Goal and four assists. Stahl kicked it in, and it's waved off.
It looks like a bit of a kicking motion. He's not trying to kick the puck, but the puck explodes off of the top of his boot, so it makes it look like it was a kicking motion.
No goal. The puck was kicked directly into the net.
Doesn't look like there's going to be any type of a review here. Bruce doesn't look like he's too happy about it.
Maybe use the whole zone 5-on-5 better than I've seen in the last several games. Maybe even a handful of games, the way they've moved.
Eller on the stop, rebound, score! Andre Burakovsky.
Beautiful backhand. Everybody will get a point on this line. They were dynamic there on the forecheck.
Dumba gains the offensive zone. Knocked into the corner by Kempe. Turn it over, Koivu fires, he scores!
try to move the puck up the middle of the ice. Guess who's there? Mikko Koivu probably gets a good chunk of it, but not quite enough. And the Wild pick up a huge goal here with 8 minutes left.
Off the draw, there's a fight.
Yep, it's going to be Tom Wilson and
Marcus Foligno.
These are two tough customers. Looked like they were talking off the faceoff.
Boy, a couple of big roundhouse rights landed each way.
I'm sure Foligno asked him to dance coming off the bench to try to keep the energy going.
Welcome back to the lineup, Tom Wilson. Joel Eriksson-Ek over skates, and Ovechkin comes away. It's a 3-on-2 developing. Alex Ovechkin closes, feeds across, score! A gorgeous pass to Dmitry Orlov.
Unreal. And this guy, Wilson, may not get an assist on this play, but he made this whole play happen. I don't think you can script a better way to execute tactically a 3-on-2. Notice Wilson cut through the middle, takes that D away. That opens up the passing lane, and it's right on the money. Orlov looking like OV the way he let that one-timer go.
Drawn up back to Backstrom right up the gut. Then Oshie, bullseye! T.J. Oshie makes it 5-1.
The last goal was textbook passing. This one just as pretty. The Caps have blown this one open.
Tom Wilson scores in his return from suspension as the Capitals defeat the Wild for an 8th straight time. With the loss, Minnesota falls in regulation on home ice for the first time this season. After the game, Wilson spoke about his goal.
That was a first for me to score and get a penalty on the same play. But I just was going hard to the net, and Snarls put it right on my tape. So it was a great pass, you know, at full speed. And I was trying to do everything I could to get out of the way. And, you know, I'll take the goal, and Kill went out there and got it done. And, you know, it was good to see.
Predators visiting the Sharks. Nashville lost in a shootout in Anaheim on Monday night, breaking an 8-game road winning streak to start the season. But the Preds still lead the league with 27 points entering Tuesday.
Joe Thornton, one goal shy of 400. Sorensen walks in, and he scores! He stayed with it, and Marcus Sorensen gets the first goal of the night. LeBanc, a shot in through a screen. Soros spotted it up, made the stop as Hurdle keeps it alive. Back for Carlson again. He scores!
Carlson head up all the way. Good torque on the shot, on the stick, and Pavelski redirects it.
That assist for Erik Karlsson, his 400th, so congratulations. And Hartman will get it back safely to his teammate, K. Subban. Sharks all over them on the forecheck.
Oh, yeah.
Here's Suomela, he scores!
Predators on the power play now, just for a brief time. Forsberg trying to work it free, centering past Johansson, backhand feed, and they score! Tapped in by Craig Smith, right as the power play was expiring. Here's a loose puck, Forsberg with a chance. Philip Forsberg driving to the net. Forsberg scores! The Predators are right back in this hockey game. It's 3-2.
Forehand, backhand, quick hands.
Now driving to the net, Burns. Can't get around the Predator defender. Nice play by Craig Smith. Now Forsberg. Takes it, toe drag, shoots, he scores! Philip Forsberg has tied this hockey game. He curls in the corner behind the net, Thornton placed it right in front, saved by Soros. He stopped Melker Carlson, outlet pass ahead, Grimaldi trying to get behind the D. Rocco Grimaldi is in, he scores! Rocco Grimaldi's first goal as a Predator, a brilliant move. And Nashville takes the lead for the first time in the game.
In the way is Pavelski, and now Josi gets around Brent Burns 2-on-1. Josi with Smith, the pass, and Jones with the glove save on Craig Smith. Thornton lets it go to Burns, who makes the play to Sorensen. Pavelski scores! We're tied! Joe Pavelski roofs it, and it's 4-4. And the Sharks come back. Sorensen and Burns, they're saying, with the assist. Here's Thornton. There it is! Number 400 for Joe Thornton! And the Sharks take the lead!
Watch this stretch pass from Braun up to Sorensen. Catches it, then holds up Thornton far side to give the Sharks a 5-4 lead.
What a hockey game tonight here in the Bay Area. The shot and wide, but kept alive by Forsberg. He'll go back to the blue line. Johansson in front. Bonino. Brandon Jones with the save. Couture against Johansson. Johansson will draw it all the way back, and that will do it. The San Jose Sharks win it here over the number one team in the NHL.
San Jose scores twice in a span of 13 seconds to avoid a devastating loss. Joe Thornton becomes the 11th player in NHL history with 400 goals and 1,000 assists. On the other side, the Preds have dropped consecutive games for the first time this season. Maple Leafs and Kings. Jonathan Quick already out with a torn meniscus, and now Jack Campbell out with the same injury. Kings now turn to Peter Budaj, who makes his first NHL start in 11 months.
And Budaj's going to have to be busy in the first minute 15. The first penalty belongs to L.A.
Back to the line for Riley. Handing it off for Marner. To Riley again. Tavares to Marner. In front scores. Dawson Pantry banks it home. The power play marker as the Leafs on the board.
The whole building thought he was going to shoot this. A little fake in the slot.
And that is absolutely a remarkable first goal for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
So quickly, the second power play for Toronto.
Tavares won the draw. Back to Morgan Riley. He'll throw towards the net. Scores! John Tavares got his stick on it, I believe, on that shot. Power play clicks again to make it 2-0.
This is just execution extraordinaire by the Maple Leafs on the power play.
The Kings are being outshot 9-0 in the first 6.5 minutes of this game.
Plays it ahead for Kyle Clifford. Clifford. Got it down low, Oshiganov.
Dion for the shot, score! Tipped in by Kempe!
Oshiganov here gets the puck behind the net, and he just throws a dandy right through the middle. I'm not quite sure what he was thinking there.
The Kings, very quickly, no hesitation, back on net. Kings back in this game.
Hyman steers the puck away from Carter's grasp and cycles to Marner. Doughty comes on to Marner, but couldn't get to the puck. Tavares dancing, Riley shooting, they score!
Wow. What a shot, Morgan Riley, top corner, and it's 3-1 Toronto.
And you see why Morgan Riley is the most dangerous offensive defenseman in the National Hockey League. He just zings it to the top.
Here's Lindholm off the boards to the point. Dermott coming in. Travis Dermott finds a little room, gets it in tight center, scores! Andreas Janssen on a great feed from Travis Dermott, and it's 4-1 Toronto.
Look at that. That's just coverage issues. It is three Leafs against one King down low, and that's something about sorting things out. That's just not following the play. It's not following the speed. Budaj gets the hook.
Not the circumstance with which Cal Peterson wanted to make his NHL debut.
So now this kid in goal is really going to get tested against this potent Maple Leaf power play for 4 minutes.
Marner on the far side. Mitch Marner with a shot in front. Marner with a chance. Scores.
Kadri crashing the goal, finished it up for his second of the night.
5-1 and counting.
Well, this is not the way the Kings wanted to end this homestand by any stretch. I follow in the final seconds with Vandenberg, a late shot, turned out by Anderson, and that does it on a 5-1 rout for the Toronto Maple Leafs over the Los Angeles Kings tonight at Staples Center.
Maple Leafs scored early and often as they chased Peter Budaj out of the net just 25 minutes into this one. Toronto is now 7-1 on the road this season. Meanwhile, Cal Peterson makes 15 saves in relief in his NHL debut. Canucks taking on the Islanders. It's Military Appreciation Day in Brooklyn. Matthew Barzal is representing the military during warm-ups for Tuesday's game. He also entered the game with 99 points in his career. He would look to make it 100 as the Islanders try and snap a three-game losing streak.
Here's Michael Delzato in behind for Brendan Leipzig along the end boards. Horvat finds some room, puts one in front. Leipzig shoots, he scores! Brendan Leipzig off the setup from Bo Horvat, and the Canucks lead 1-0.
No chance for Thomas Greisel.
Filppula back into the corner. Can Branson and Komarov come together? Komarov lost the stick, puck stayed there. Kunockel draws a penalty, and then as he was falling, he scores! Tom Kunockel, count it, and we're tied at one.
Watching Leo Komarov, and he, after Kunockel fell down and they started to blow the whistle, Komarov went over to the net and he pointed to the net. He said, ref, had pucks in. So what a great effort by the two guys.
Here's Matt Barzal circling to the middle of the ice, had it on the backhand, still stuck there. Cuts back on Pulia, opens up in front. Lee creates an opening and it banks in. Josh Bailey trying to feed it to Anders Lee, and
for the Islanders right now.
Their response is 2 goals in 45 seconds and a 2-1 lead on the goal credited to Josh Bailey. Matt Barzell will get an assist on that, so mark that down as Matt Barzell's 100th career point in game number 101 of his National Hockey League career. Andrew Ladd touched it deep, so no icing. Then Everly scores! Brock Nelson to Jordan Everly, and the Islanders have scored three straight. Brock Nelson, one number 200 of his career.
30 seconds left in the power play. Leipzig back to Hutton. Leipzig with room. Let's go with a wrist shot. Stop for 10 and scores on the rebound. Jake for 10 and put it up under the bar. And the Canucks are within one with a power play goal.
Brock Nelson moves it around the back of the net for Everly. In front, Kunako scores! Tom Kunako, his second of the game, and the Islanders are ahead 4-2 for the moment. The call on the ice is a good goal. You're allowed to direct the puck into the net, you just can't kick it. And so was that a distinct kicking motion for Tom Kunako? Here's Dean Morton.
After video review, it is determined the play is a good goal.
4-2 Islanders. Still 2.5 to go on a double minor for high sticking to Jake Virtanen. Barzell, Clutterbuck scores! That was a long time coming for Cal Clutterbuck. And the Islanders power play.
Clutterbuck was open up and had an opportunity, and that's all it took was a little mistake.
Led by Tom Kunako's first career multi-goal effort, Islanders snapped their three-game winless skid. Andrew Ladd, meanwhile, left with a leg injury. He's going to be reevaluated on Wednesday. On the other side, Elias Pettersson goes scoreless in his first two Big Apple contests. Coming up here on the fly, we'll check out the Panthers in action and tell you what Evgeny Dadonov and Mike Hoffman did that hasn't happened in the NHL in longer than a decade. Keep it right here.
I like what I'm seeing from the Sabres right now.
Look out for the Buffalo Sabres.
Have to go for the center of the score. And second chance, rebound. It's in behind the score. That's Skinner with the goal.
The Buffalo Sabres are suddenly right in the thick of things.
They played very well.
Right now, everything's going the Sabres' way.
They're on another level.
It's nice to have a good start. We got to make sure that we keep the battle down and keep it going.
One of the best stories of the season thus far has been the success of the Buffalo Sabres. Buffalo, who had the fewest points in the NHL a season ago, would make the playoffs if the season ended today. But it's going to be the Sabres' next five contests that are going to serve as a true barometer for how far Buffalo has come in just a year. Sabres will face 2018 playoff teams in five straight games. Those squads have a collective point percentage over 650. Stretch begins with the Tampa Bay Lightning, who come into play having scored at least 4 goals in 5 straight games. So could Buffalo slow them down on Tuesday?
Here's Johnson into the zone with the shot, smothered by the defense, got it back, got it on goal, Hutton a save, and it's fired wide now by McDonough. Carter Hutton, couple of beautiful stops there.
High slot stamp goes off his stick, and it comes out to center ice. Scandella, maybe an on-man rush here, 2-on-2 actually. Reinhardt across the blue line. High slot, shoots, Sam Domingue with the glove, and he holds on.
Both goalies putting on a pretty good show early. Dahlin, watched by Gord. Now it's Reinhardt shooting, and they score! Skinner popped it in, out in front. And Buffalo opens the scoring at 17:45.
Phil Housley has talked about getting more shots, and it's just getting to that dirty area right there. Domingue, you can see him looking around, trying to find where that puck is.
Lightning surrendering that first goal. It's the eighth time in the last 9 games they've surrendered the first goal. Puck taken by Gord. He'll circle back at center. Blast through a check from Sobotka. Here's Girardi off the angle. Shooting pad save by Hutton. Scrambled in front. Hutton trying to find the puck, and he covers it up.
How many Buffalo Sabres in that screenshot right there? The frustration is mounting here for Tampa Bay Lightning as they're getting their opportunities, and they're not able to bury them.
As Sheary gains the line for Buffalo. Quick shot. They score! Kyle Okposo fires that home to make it 2-0 Buffalo.
Big goal for the Buffalo Sabres. They withstood some serious pressure at the beginning of this period from the Lightning. This goal is caused by Connor Sheary. Watch him get this puck with so much speed through the neutral zone. Not only does he feed the puck to Okposo, but then he drives the net.
Now the Sabres with the 2-0 lead.
Now here's Cirelli, a breakaway. Cirelli in alone. Score! Oh, what a pass to Anthony Cirelli! It was like a bomb in football over the top, and he skated behind the defense, got that puck, and lifted it over the glove of Hutton. The Lightning answered the Okposo goal in the next shift.
15 seconds later, Tampa Bay's cut that lead in half. Off the glass it comes. Point gets a hold of it. Scandella could get it by Point. Closing in. Nice move. And Hutton just disrupted the move. He made the stop there. Once again, Carter Hutton's got the answer. Down off the boards. Makes the play out to Cirelli. From the outlet, he scrambles to center. With Killorn stepping in. And Dolly shooting glove. Save Hutton. Maybe his best of the night right there to keep that lead in the hands of the Buffalo Sabres. The Lightning six skaters on. Deflected off the glass behind the net. Tampa Bay hangs on to it. Miller now to Kucherov. Shooting off the goal post. And it's top three and out of the zone by Ristolainen. Kucherov, he's got it with 9 seconds. Shoved to the ice by Ristolainen. Hedman at the point. Stamkos stops it. Waits. Feeds it back. Kucherov shoots. Another goal post. Nikita Kucherov slamming the glass with his stick, hitting two posts in the final minute. And the Sabres hang on for a 2-1 win.
So despite being outshot 30-19, the Sabres matched their season-high win streak with a third straight victory. Lightning, meanwhile, have dropped consecutive games in regulation for the first time this season. After the game, Jeff Skinner talked about the team's recent success.
Yeah, that's a good team over there. I think they played a good game. I think penalty kill did a good job, and obviously Hutz did a great job. D-Man, I thought, did a great job blocking some big shots, and yeah, definitely something we can build off of. Ike's obviously is one of the best centermen in the league. He kind of dictates the play out there. Fortunately for us, we've been going pretty good lately, I think, and hopefully we can keep it going.
Panthers visit the Flyers as Mike Hoffman chases history. With a point on Tuesday, Hoffman could tie Pavel Bure's club record 13-game point streak set back during the 1999-2000 season.
Here's Sanhan. Cross-ice Gudas takes a shot, deflected just wide, and chipped on goal. Luongo down.
He was trying to bat the puck in from behind. Not sure how Luongo was able to keep that one out.
Huberdeau comes over, got that puck to choke check back, and Huberdeau's shot is denied by Elliott, his best save of the night. There's a bit of a breakdown defensively for the Flyers there, but Elliott erased it. Turnover by Giroux here, and it's Barkov the other way. Barkov holds his shot, and that one sticked away by Elliott. And he got back to get a piece of Barkov, and that disrupted the shot. Puck comes across, Dadonoff fanning, gets it back, fires, blocked by Haig, rebound, Elliott the save! Oh, what a stop on Hoffman, and he keeps this game scoreless.
Boy, what a job by Brian Elliott to keep that pad solid, his left pad. But again, this sure requires leg strength and presence of mind to know exactly where the puck is.
Hoffman's got it. Driving that 12-game point streak, looking for a chance. He may have one here. Sends it in front. Oh, what a save by Elliott. And Ekblad scores. Power play goal. Aaron Ekblad. I believe Hoffman extends his streak as well. And it's 1-0 Panthers.
There's Hoffman with a punch. And it goes off the goaltender. Then it gets to number 5. That's Ekblad. Off the stick, blocker, and in the net. Hoffman, congratulations.
Centering, look who's there in front, position perfectly. The captain, Barkov. Leads Dadonoff into the zone. Dadonoff shoots and scores! The daddy with a rocket, and it's 2-0 Panthers. And Dadonoff extends his point streak to a dozen.
I think Elliott thought he was dropping the puck to Barkov, and that was enough to beat him top shelf.
Makes a play at one goal line and then the other, and here he comes. Barkov into the backhand, saved by Elliott. And now the Flyers in the counter rush. It's Couturier with Lindblom. Couturier for Lindblom. He gets his step from the angle, centers it back, the shot. They score! Voracek beating Luongo. Flyers within one. Marked down the save at the other end by Elliott as he kept the Flyers within two, and then they get within one courtesy of Voracek.
Good defensive work there by the Flyers. Patrick to the Panther line. Lindblom is in. He hit the post. And then Luongo, the great save on the follow by Patrick. Roberto keeps the Panthers on top. Giroux down low. Gostisbehere fires. Luongo down. Trying to hold. still loose side of the net, behind the net with five. It's cleared, and that's five in a row for the Panthers. They beat the Flyers 2-1 here in Philadelphia.
A big one for Roberto Luongo, career win number 475 as the Panthers win their fifth straight game. With Mike Hoffman recording an assist, he ties Pavel Bure for the longest point streak in Panthers history at 13 games. Hoff also has the longest point streak so far this season. So with Mike Hoffman and Evgeny Dadonov both recording a point Tuesday, they became the first pair of teammates to have simultaneous point streaks of at least 12 games since Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin each had streaks of 13 games in the 2007-2008 season. Coming up, the day after being inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame, Martin Brodeur returns to the place he built his legend. Brodeur back in New Jersey when we come back.
We're all pretty disappointed in the way this trip's gone.
Cross, Stamkos scores, and the Lightning are pouring it on.
Unbelievable. That's the way it's gone.
Red Wings defeat the Devils.
Oh, boy. Now when it rains, it pours.
The net empty. The Islanders have locked it up. But 18 goals surrendered over these final three losses on the road trip. The Devils' seven-game road trip comes to an end. They finish it 1-6.
The Devils began the season 4-0. Looked like they had taken another step forward after being one of the most surprising teams last year. But since that early win streak, it's been tough treading for John Hines' squad. New Jersey is 2-8-1 in their last 11 games, including a 1-6 road trip, and saw the Devils get outscored 34-17 overall. Unfortunately, it gets worse. New Jersey will suit up against the Penguins on Tuesday without their number one center, Nico Hischier. He's going to miss his first game in his young career. So could New Jersey rally to secure a much-needed win?
Tonight, we welcome him back to the Rock for the first time as a member of the Hockey Hall of Fame, number 30, Martin Brodeur.
Puck taken back by Hall. Taylor Hall turns, sends towards goal. That got through. Rebound loose. Still loose. They score. Travis Zajac. DeSmith had two chances to cover the puck. He could not. And the Devils strike first.
From the corner, winds it up high. Letang, point to point. Dumoulin wristing it down low, wide with a purpose. Comes to Crosby. Trying to tuck it. Hall digging for it. It was shut down by Kincaid up against the post.
Crosby's able to get to that far post. Boy, oh, that thing just wouldn't go in. The second chance right there. It goes up and hits the knob of his stick.
Evgeny Malkin from the circle all the way across to Crosby, right at the dot. Dusts it off, spins it back in front. Kessel, he scores! Phil Kessel!
It looks like Kessel did get his stick between the legs of Lovejoy and then off Lovejoy's glove and then back down off a pad and then in off the net. That's great stuff. Follow the bouncy puck.
Tries to maneuver by Johnson. Centering try. Save made by DeSmith. That was Taylor Hall with the chance. On the puck again is Hall. Drops it back. Severson scores! David Severson let it rip. Devils have the lead.
Taylor Hall gets it back behind the net. He finds a wide open David Severson, and he absolutely lets her fly.
Devils trying to snap a three-game losing skid. Long pass ahead. Here's Brad. Scores! And there's a fight behind the play.
Oh my, this is going to be interesting. They were just engaging, and now the referees and linesmen are huddling around.
There's no goal on the play. The whistle is gone.
And here come the Penguins shorthanded. Matt Cullen, Rust, in tight, save by Kincaid!
Kincaid with the glove kind of bats out the rolling puck, because it looked like it still might go across the line, hits the post and sits there. A lot of action.
Mata chips it up the boards, a touch by Kessel, a good one. Here comes Crosby rushing ahead. Two on two at Gensel. Crosby toward the net, he shoots, that rebound, Gensel, he scores!
On the follow-up, Jake Gensel has tied this game up at two.
Along the near wall to work this ahead. Zajac will play this across. Here's Hall, scores!
Slides it through the five hole.
Hall has the speed to get on this. The net is empty. Scores! And the Devils are on their way to kissing a three-game losing streak goodbye.
Great reigning MVP Taylor Hall records his eighth career four-point effort as the Devils win for just the second time in eight games. As for the Pens, they are now 1-4-1 against Metro teams this season. After the game, Hall spoke about what this win meant to his team after struggling on the road.
We haven't been playing the way we wanted to, but tonight was a really good step in the right direction. So all around goaltending, our defensive zone, and finally on offense, we're pretty good tonight, so we've got to keep that going. We won a game against a pretty good team tonight, and it's about kind of learning from that. Season's really long. We have a lot of hockey left to be played, and if you look at the Metro right now, it's pretty tight. So just stay in our own lane, correct some things, but at the same time, that was a pretty solid game.
Canadiens at the Oilers in Alberta. Edmonton entered Tuesday on a four-game losing skid, scoring just six times in that span. But on the other hand, Montreal netted 10 over their last two.
Gajula behind the net for Drysdale. Near side, McDavid back up top. Here it comes from Benning, and he whistles it wide, and it goes in. A favorable bounce for the home team, and it's 1-0 for Edmonton.
This is a bounce right now the Oilers needed. They wanted to come out and have a good start. It was imperative for them to do that, losing the last four. And this one just caroms off the back wall, really aggressively catches Niemi in the back of the skate and goes into his own net.
One shot on the power play for the Edmonton Oilers as Juleson's on his feet. He's out of the box and he comes out quickly and breaks up that play. And here comes Domi in. Fire scores! Max Domi continues to be red hot for the Montreal Canadiens as Domi now on a seven-game point streak.
He's coming back in a good position. He sees that the puck is loose, and he makes no hesitation.
Back the other way, McDavid. McDavid lined up by Slimko. Gets by him. Right on his front! His 11th goal of the year. The Oilers take back the lead.
Schlemko doesn't get a piece of him. He's able to walk in, get control once again. Petrie comes over a little too far, trying to play McDavid. That allows for the pass to Dreisaitl, and he puts this one by Niemi.
And a race for it to Jarkera, shorthanded. Kera! Stopped by Niemi. The Oilers looking for their third shorthanded goal of the season.
Petrie, over 8 minutes in that first period. The leading ice getter for the Montreal Canadiens, Drouin, behind the net, hit front, shot, scores! Andrew Shaw, big-time goal for Montreal as the Habs tie it up.
Keeping the puck in, another real good play by Jeff Petrie, and now they work it from below the goal line. And you see Drouin take a little look ahead of time, and then Shaw jumps right into that space.
Led the charge, he's turned aside, and back the other way comes Gajula. Right, Gajula leaves it for Chiasson, winds and fires. Niemi makes the save, goes up in the air. Gajula with a chance, he scores. Great, Gajula got that one out of the air. And the Oilers have a 3-2 lead.
Under 3 minutes to go now in the second period. Stretched up for McDavid. Connor McDavid, space waits in front. Shot, oh, what a stop by Niemi as he robs Dreisaitl.
Keeping his team within one.
Strom goes cross ice. Finds Nugent Hopkins, cuts to the middle, steps a shot, he scores!
Gets himself into a spot, separates himself from the defenders, walks to the middle on that nice drive through the middle on by Lucic to open it up for him.
Down low for Brodziak, across to Kara. Kara back up top. Gravel to Russell. Russell, a wrist shot, scores! Chris Russell came into the game without a goal in 42 games. That ends tonight as he gets his first of the season. The Oilers have five on the night.
How about Edmonton's blue line matching its season total for goals by a defenseman with three in this one? Oilers snapped their four-game losing skid while also beating the Canadiens for the eighth time in 10 meetings. Coming up, we're going to head to Bridgestone Arena where the Predators played host to all-pro NFL cornerback Jalen Ramsey. Ramsey have a second career in hockey? We'll let him tell you next.
The Red Wings win it. Vancouver's three-game win streak is over. The Red Wings back in the win column.
Redirection. Marcus scores.
5 seconds.
Game at three. Shut down by Bernier. Detroit wins.
You know, what a week it's been for Detroit. Three come from behind victories.
All winning streaks are created differently. Take, for instance, the Red Wings' modest three-game win streak entering Tuesday. In each of those games, Detroit has trailed by at least two goals. In fact, the Wings are one of only eight teams in NHL history to overcome multi-goal deficits to win three straight regular season games. And despite Detroit's below 500 record, they've won six of their last seven to become one of the hottest teams in the league. So, could the Wings make it four straight as they welcome the Coyotes to Little Caesars Arena?
Hockey Fights Cancer Night here at the arena.
More than 100 cancer patients, survivors, doctors, caregivers, and supporters were here on hand for a very special VIP morning. They got to meet and greet some Red Wing players.
Back comes Mantha, kicked ahead. He's got Fisher, the forward, playing back. Takes him wide. Oh. Scores!
Look at that. He's hot. Look at that shot by Mantha. He knows exactly where he wants to go. Top corner, over the catching glove. He got a piece of it, Kemper, but Detroit gets the lead, which they also wanted.
Back to the line, holding it into Kaiser, to Chalosky. Right circle, another shot, he scores! That puck was in and out in a hurry, and the Red Wings lead 2-0.
Red Wings have scored 1-5-on-3 of the first two times they had the advantage. Jalmerson, one of the better shot blockers in the league. Oh. Scores! Oh. Rasmussen from Larkin, 3-0.
And then Rasmussen, big, strong, on his knees. Watch that blade of the stick right there. Wow, nicely done. Dylan Larkin hit the target.
Osterley in over the line. Strome with it. Strome right to the net. They score! Christian Fisher set up by Strome to finish it off. It's a 3-1 game.
What a pass.
Two things they may look at here. Possibly offside, and two, the kick-in.
Detroit is using their coach's challenge for offside prior to the goal.
And watch this guy skates. Hold it right there. He's
already offside.
He's in.
Video review. It was determined the play was offside. No goal.
Applicator got it.
This.
And alone from center ice, Luke Glendening scores!
Wow. Full-strength goal.
Yep, even strength
goal. Right as the penalty expired, for all purposes, it's a shorthanded goal. And all I could say about that, with the Coyotes having 9 shorthanded goals this year, is there's a little bit of your own medicine, boy.
Even though not officially a shorthand,
right.
You're right. Yep.
Kicker in, laying it back as they get it set up in the Red Wing zone. Destroza to Osterley with a shot blocked, and on the penalty box on a breakaway. Anthony Seu going in all alone. He scores on a backhand upstairs.
Wow. That's the kind of night I'm saying it's been for the Red Wings. It's all going their way.
He's been on fire. He came out of the box. Scores on a backhand, top shelf, and it's 5-0 Detroit.
So no rally necessary in this game as the Red Wings blow out the Coyotes to win their fourth straight game and sixth in 7 contests overall. Most of the Wings contributed on the score sheet. 13 of the 18 skaters picked up at least a point. Just before they dropped the puck in Detroit, the Coyotes announced that they signed defenseman Jacob Chychrun to a 6-year extension worth $27.6 million. 2016 first-round pick made his season debut on Tuesday due to off-season knee surgery. Registered 3 shots in just over 20 minutes. NFL cornerback Jalen Ramsey made waves earlier this year when he proclaimed that he could play in the NHL with just 6 months of training. So leave it to the Nashville Predators to give him a shot. Kind of. Predators invited Ramsey to his first hockey game earlier this month at Bridgestone Arena. Here's how it played out.
Hey, y'all. Welcome to Smashville, home of the Nashville Predators. I'm Paul Bissonnette, a.k.a. Biz Nasty, and I'm your host of NHL First Timer, where we give your casual fan a VIP experience to the greatest game on earth. Let's go meet our guest.
Ladies and gentlemen, the special guest we've all been waiting for, Jalen Ramsey.
What's up?
And Jalen, I even got you a special jersey. This is authentic. This is what the players will be wearing on the ice during warm-up tonight. I was a guy to watch and warm up. My backhand saucer passes, my between the legs deeks.
Go teach me some of that stuff?
Yeah, sure. So PK is going nuts in warm-up. He always got the quick feet going. All-time NHL leader in warm-up goals. Not a big deal. Can Jalen drive the Zamboni? Here we are, the Jersey Carousel.
Ooh! Ready to get on
Welcome
that
to
ice?
The squad. Take a picture like it's a cover of a rap album. Yo, country mixtape dropping soon. Yodel. What's the matter? Not down with the cut. Oh, is that how you do it? Sorry. I messed that one up. Cut that one out, Posh. How do I act cool? I found my soulmate.
Oh, yeah.
I found my soulmate.
Who wore it best? I need to get with the program, huh?
And beat the Lightning on Thursday.
Grab it. Marcy wants one.
Let's go.
Here they come the other way. Johansson.
Oh, yeah, get it.
To Forsberg.
Marshawn, he's the Taylor Ramsey of hockey.
So you still think you can hang with these guys in 6 months? You're going to have to get the skating now.
I know, that's the hardest part, probably.
I'll teach you.
The enormous body of Chara.
Yeah, that dude is way too tall.
Mushroom, number 25, 2 minutes. Home.
Get him with the rolly, get him with the rolly.
Oh, yeah, get him with
the rolly. You know, I had a blast in the lower bowl, but it got too much getting recognized. I mean, I kept getting asked for autographs, and I felt bad for Jalen. He had to kind of trail behind me there. $5 an autograph, three for 20.
That's my hockey agent.
You know, it was really humbling when they asked me to jump on the TV broadcast, too.
Of course, PK.
PK, I love it.
PK, that's my favorite player, man. I like a couple guys, though. PK, Ryan Johansson.
Guys, Ryan Johansson and Roman Josi were nice enough to give us their box tonight. And hey, we didn't put this on PK's tab for you not to wear it. So throw that on, too. Perfect.
Thought there was going to be something in there?
Uh-oh. Oh, here he is. Hoyle's trying to get contract negotiations going already with Jalen. Let's just keep it friendly. No contract negotiations.
That was a really good period for us. I think we're going to stay with the same team right now.
Okay. We're going to put you down in the AHL.
I think you're the most winningest GM in all of hockey.
Here a very long time.
That's a good start. I'll see you both at practice tomorrow.
Yeah. Oh, I'm getting a deal too?
Yeah.
Sure. We have practice then, right?
Let me call my folks.
We'll be there tomorrow.
I mean, Poyle's the best GM on the planet, and for him to sign me, I guess that tells you everything you need to know about my skill level. So, who knows, maybe I'll be a Predator soon enough. Jalen, we're about halfway through your first NHL game experience. What are you thinking so far?
I'm loving it. I got to see a goal. Only one, though, so it's been a defensive game. But I'm a defensive guy. I'm respecting the goaltending right now in the defense.
Jalen Ramsey, welcome home to Smashville.
The Jacksonville Jaguars are rivals to the Tennessee Titans, so I kind of expected a little bit.
Marshawn breaks in, shoots, saved by Reed. Rebound loose, and kicked out to the point.
Hey, yo, these last minute is intense.
Krejci turns up ice quickly. Puck, and time has expired.
We gotta see what you're made of. You've been talking a lot of game.
Let's do it.
Let's see if you can even raise this puck. Let's see what you got, babe.
Oh, you gotta give me some pointers or something first, though.
Okay, so all right. So you wanna bend your knees a little bit, all right? You wanna get in there. Yeah, let's see what you got.
Oh. I was trying to pass it.
Yeah, no, it was a good pass.
I definitely think Biz held back on giving me some shooting tips because he didn't want me to one-up him. He didn't want me to look too good in my debut.
I'm going
to
give you a one-timer. Whoa, not bad. Okay, let's go again. Warm it up. Bring it in, buddy. That's good team chem.
We might have one of the best damn duos, though.
Hey, tell them about my shooting out there.
You were giving them lessons?
No, we're...
What up, man? Enjoy?
I did. We were working on our one tees in your little sticker.
I heard that he doesn't turn the wrist over, though. He likes to just a straight wrist.
Well, he doesn't raise
the... See, y'all didn't tell me all that, though. Y'all didn't tell me I had to turn the wrist over.
No, okay, we're going to start in Milwaukee, but... Where's my jersey?
Yeah.
What do you think I get on eBay for this?
This is how we really are in the games.
Man, this is tight. I'm ready, baby. I'm ready.
You already know what it is, baby. Nashville's finest.
Yeah.
And we pretty, too.
Yeah.
Pretty, too. What?
I don't know if I can make the NHL with only 6 months of training, but I might be better than Biz in 6 months. I guess we'll never know.
Oh, absolutely love that. Coming up, Max Domi was calm and collected when he scored his 10th goal of the season on Tuesday. So how could a harmless prank have Domi sweating bullets? We'll tell you next. But first, check out our top shelf plays of the night, presented by Tin Cup.
Back into the corner, could Branson and Komarov come together? Komarov lost the stick, puck stayed there. Kunockel draws a penalty. And then as he was falling, he scores!
Watch him, spins around, trying to control it, gets pulled down, and in desperation, throws it towards the net. That's a great effort.
Comes Mantha, kicked ahead. He's got Fisher, the forward, playing back. Takes him wide, oh. Scores!
Look at that, he's hot. Look at that shot by Mantha. He knows exactly where he wants to go. Top corner, over the catching glove. He got a piece of it, Kemper.
Rust will work it across, and here come the Penguins shorthanded. Matt Cullen, Rust in tight, save by Kincaid!
Great glove save. Kincaid with the glove kind of bats out the rolling punch. It looked like it still might go across line.
It's the eighth time in the last nine games they've surrendered the first goal. Now here's Cirelli, he's alone, scores! Anthony Cirelli answers right back.
Watch this flip play from Alex Killorn coming from his atop his defensive zone perfectly right to Cirelli, who does a good job of settling that bouncing puck and roofs it.
Sergei Forlin, Lonnie gets a step from the angle, set it to back the shot, they score! Voracek!
Jake Voracek finished, unbelievable. It has to be perfect to beat Luongo the way he's played tonight, and this one is. What a pass!
Nous sommes à même un beau jeu pour plaquer la rondelle. Et voilà Domi, le tir!
Wow! He's coming back in a good position. He sees that the puck is loose, and he makes no hesitation.
Alex Ovechkin closes, feeds across, score! A gorgeous pass to Dmitry Orlov.
Orlov looking like OV the way he let that one-timer go.
Connor McDavid, space waits in front, shot!
Top Shelf Plays of the Night is presented by Tin Cup Mountain Whiskey.
With his first goal of the season and two assists against the Coyotes, it was Green's first three-point effort in more than a calendar year. Second star goes to Jumbo Joe Thornton with the game-winning goal against the Predators. It was a milestone one at that, the 400th goal of what has been a spectacular career for him. Your first star goes to Taylor Hall, two goals and two assists. His first four-point effort of the season in the Devils' 4-2 win over the Penguins. Before we leave you tonight, we're going to head out to Montreal, where Max Domi has made his presence felt through the early part of the season, but didn't stop his new team from testing the breaking point of their young star. Check out Domi trying to figure out what's in the box.
I'm so scared right now, bro.
Keep going.
Turtle, bro.
No, it's not a turtle. That's wood. You're touching the wood right now.
Could he move?
Here, let me direct your hand.
Okay, can I guess?
Yes.
A rock.
Oh, I hate snakes. That's going to do it for us on the fly. Thanks for joining us. We'll leave you with the best images from the night that was.
Happy Tuesday, everybody. Nine games on tap tonight. It'll be a busy night.
The Red Wings get set to take the ice on this Hockey Fights Cancer night here in the Motor City. Tapping hands with some survivors.
Tonight, we welcome him back to the Rock for the first time as a member of the Hockey Hall of Fame, number 30, Martin Brodeur.
Here comes Max Domi back the other way. Domi shot, scores!
Max Domi continues to be red hot for the Montreal Canadiens.
And then as he was falling, he scores!
And that's five in a row for the Panthers!
Welcome back to the lineup, Tom Wilson.
Exactly where he wants to go. Top corner, over the catching glove. Here's Thornton.